Did you know that there are tiny creatures living on your face right now? Yes, I'm talking about face mites. These microscopic organisms that inhabit your skin and hair follicles, they're fascinating, creepy, and surprisingly pretty common. But what are these mites, and should you be worried about them? In today's video, we're diving into everything you need to know about face mites, what they are, how they grow, who's at risk, and most importantly, how to get rid of them and keep them from coming back. Let's get started. Also, real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below. And if you enjoy the content, turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. We talk about all things hair, skin, and health. So if that's something you're into, definitely consider subscribing. It might give you the creepy crawlies, but you almost certainly have tiny mites living in the pores of your face right now as you're watching YouTube. And there's even evidence that they play a role in rosacea for some folks. They're known as Demodex, and just about every adult has a population living on them. There are about 65 types of these mites, but the two most common ones are Demodex folliculorum, which hang out near the eyelashes, and Demodex brevis, which hangs out near your oil glands and eats the sebum your skin produces. And you won't be able to see the mites on your face because, first off, they're about 0.3 millimeters long, and secondly, they spend their days face down inside your hair follicles, nestled up against your hair shaft where you can't really see them. The mites live there for about 2 weeks, and while you're asleep, they crawl out onto the skin surface to mate, and then the females head back to lay their eggs about 1 to 5 millimeters below the surface. And since they live inside your pores, it's hard to just scrub them off by washing. But don't worry, we'll get into a way to get rid of them in just a second. And the population of these mites often peak in those who are about 20 to 30 years old. It's interesting because this is the age group where sebum production is at a higher rate anyway. In other words, the more oil you produce, the more food you give them. Now, it's important to note that face mites are a normal part of healthy skin, and it seems our immune system is able to keep them from overgrowing. But some people can experience problems with their mites when their population gets out of hand. A few conditions that can arise when they overgrow are demodicosis, which is basically an infestation of the pores, leaving almost this white sheen on the face, Demodex folliculitis, possible hair loss, blepharitis, which is an inflammatory eyelid condition. Interestingly, 30 to 90% of cases can be attributed back to these mites, and even rosacea. Those that are more risk for their overgrowth are if you're immunocompromised, if you have very oily skin, if you overuse hydrocortisone creams on the skin, and if you have rosacea and other skin conditions. And yes, it is possible to spread them from skin to skin. It's a common transfer actually when you kiss someone who has an infestation. You can easily pass them on to others too. So how do you get rid of them is the big question. The first place I would start is to see if you can rule out demodicosis. You want to make sure to address demodicosis first if you suspect it to be a case. Typically, you do not need to see a healthcare provider for face mites unless you have symptoms of it. So if you have a white sheen to the skin, itchy skin, dryness, redness, acne that won't improve, sores from scratching, or what is known as that Demodex frost, get that resolved first and see if it's tied back to these face mites. Secondly, tea tree oil is going to be your best friend. It is the most effective solution since it contains terpenin 4-ol, which has been shown to destroy the Demodex mites. So go ahead and look for products like cleansers, creams, or oils containing tea tree oil. I left one that does the job in the description below as an affiliate link should you wish to go with that one. It's the Cliradex Wipes, which are super, super effective. It's an absolute game changer, especially if you have blepharitis. And you want to apply it as part of your nightly skincare routine as mites are more active at night. Because remember, when you sleep at night, they come out to play. You want the tea tree oil strategically there to destroy them just as they surface. And once you get them under control, here are a few key pointers that may help keep the mites from multiplying again. The first one, when you're washing your face twice a day, don't forget to focus on the eyelids. This is especially true if you wear greasy makeup. Make sure it comes all off before bed. Second, avoid oil-based cleansers. Third, wash your pillowcase once or twice a week. A single pillowcase contains around 3 million bacteria after a week without washing, which is crazy. And fourth, exfoliate. This is going to cut off the food supply for the mites. And lastly, keep your stress in check, because having high stress means you have a weaker immune system, which seems to open the door wide for these mites.